Ozark Highlands Radio is brought to you by the Ozark Folk Center State Park in Mountain View, Arkansas, a wonderful way to enjoy yesterday. On the web at ozarkfolkcenter.com.
Hey folks, this is Dave Smith, host of Ozark Highlands Radio. Welcome to our show. If you like good guitar picking, you won't want to miss this week's show. We'll feature some fantastic pickers from our yearly tribute to the late, great Merle Travis, including some recordings of Merle himself from the 1979 Merle Travis tribute. And Mark Jones will take us down to the vault for a fine old song from local pickers Dean Hinesley and Andre Kennard. That's this week on Ozark Highlands Radio. In 1979, the Ozark Folk Center State Park created an event to honor thumbpicking legend Merle Travis. In the early days, the weekend featured a thumbpicking contest and performances from the late Merle Travis and other popular guitarists. Over the years, the event has continued on and now hosts Merle's son, Thom Bresh, as the feature performer each year. Thom has led an incredible, multifaceted life in the entertainment business. He was raised in California during the golden age of television and worked as a stuntman and actor during his youth. He went on to become one of the premier practitioners of his father's thumbpicking style of guitar. Harnessing a quick wit and an equally quick set of 10 fingers, there's nothing like a Thom Bresh performance.
I'm gonna make like a leaf and kind of blow. Thank you so much. Oh boy, I've had a good time this time up here at the Travis Festival and being up here in Mountain View. We're talking about how long I've been coming here. Travis died in 83. I think I was here like a year after that, like 85. So I thank you guys for coming up here and supporting this. And I'm gonna do a couple of Travis songs, because that's what it's all about. Do this song that Travis actually wrote this about his friend Mose Reger. Because Mose was a big influence on Travis. Mose and Ike Everly and them would play up at the company store like on Saturday night, and they'd have a dance and a fight at the end. Always had a fight at the end. And Travis said he just wrote this about Mose. Mose always played this lick, you know, that's what he said. He said, so I just made up a tune around it. I'm gonna do it for you. It's called Guitar Rag, from the movie Guitar Rag that starred Robert Mitchum and J-Lo. It was a nice one. It's making this stuff up, folks. There's no J-Lo. Down in old Kentucky, there's a fella mighty lucky, by the way, makes a guitar moan. Hanging around, singing around the country store, just picking like a chicken, picking up corn, and every gal in the county gathers all around him. He's got rhythm in his bones. Feet start scooting with the shuffle and drag every time I hear the rhythm of the guitar rag. Makes a groan in tone, it gets a grumble and groan. Yeah, when you make the picking and the plucking the strings, you can make the deacon do the bucking wang. All the fat and the skinny does a little shimmy and the head starts wiggling wang. Feet start scooting with the shuffle and drag every time I hear the rhythm of the guitar ragging like that. It's a moaning tone, it's a grumbling groan. Shake that thing, baby. Yeah, you can make a jackrabbit chase a hound. You can make the deacon let the good book down. All the fat and the skinny does a little shimmy, and the head starts to wiggle and wag. Feet start scooting with shoving and drag every time I hear the rhythm of the guitar rack. Start scooting with the shuffle and drag every time I hear the rhythm of the guitar rack. Thank you. Well, come and listen. You fellas, so young and so fine. Yeah, seek not your fortune in a dark, dreary mind. It'll form as a habit and seep in your soul till the stream of your blood runs as black as coal. Well, it's dark as a dungeon, damp as the dew, where danger is double and the pleasures are few. Where the rain never falls and the sun never shines, it's dark as a dungeon, way down here. I'm gone and the ages shall roll, my body will blacken, you good man, and turn into coal. And I look from the door of my heavenly home, my father, and I do who I want. Pity the miner digging my bone. Well, it's dark as a dungeon, damp as the dew, where danger is double and the pleasure is few. Well, the rain never falls and the sun never shined. Oh, it's dark as a dungeon, way down in a mine. It's dark as a dungeon, way down there in the mine. I'm gonna tell you something tonight. I don't think I've ever told an audience before. I mean, I've told people, but I think an audience. I used to say to Travis, he would talk about how he's not a folk songwriter. These aren't folk songs because I made them up. Folk song is like this fellows say something and then he pops in with something else that fits, and then you know somebody else says something. Next thing you know, you got a song. Folk song. And he says these things that they're making a big deal about me, they're not folk songs because I made them up. They ain't true folk songs. I said, well, you know, like Dark as a Dungeon is considered an incredible, a great folk song. Mott, that's what he called me. That's Tom backwards. Mott, let me explain to you how Dark as a Dungeon was written. I was in Redondo Beach on that old Indian motorcycle I had. Remember that? Yeah. I was over there, and I was having a home-cooked meal on the beach in this little house, a little apartment sort of thing. This beautiful lady made, and we had some drinks and told stories, and I picked and sang that sort of thing over there for her. And the next thing you know, it was like 2:30 in the morning, And I thought, oh no, I got to get back to the San Fernando Valley. Those days they didn't have freeways. I'd ride that Indian through the passes and all that. And I had to get home because I was supposed to be making up folk songs for Capitol Records. Write folk songs. People are buying folk songs. So he says, I got out there and straddled that Indian, getting ready to take off. And the only thing I could see, it was dark out there. And the only thing I could see way down the way is a lone street lamp. I thought, boy, that looks like it did when I was a kid. I'd look in the mines and I'd see one carbide lamp way down there. And I thought, oh, I'm supposed to be writing folk songs. And I reached in, got my saddlebag, and I got out my pad and my pen. And all great folk songs, most of them came from Ireland. So I started out, now listen, ye fellers, so young and so fine. And seek not, you didn't say regularly, if you're going to be folk song, you say it backwards, like, and seek not your fortune in the dark, dreary mind. It'll form as a habit and seep in your soul till the blood in your veins runs as black as the coal. Now, ain't that good? I said, yeah. Now, that's how a folk song is written. Sitting on an Indian motorcycle after making love to a beautiful girl in Redondo Beach. That's how a folk song is written. So I'm not a folk songwriter. Really? Well, so that's a little inside story that not many people know, but now they do, see? Here's one of those songs that he said he never liked it. There's no truth in it except for the one line. It's the only truthful thing in the whole song. I never cared for it. Until Tennessee Ernie Ford sold 5 million copies of it. That might have been the time it became my favorite folk song of all time. This thing's been cut 1,500 plus times, every language in the world, but it ain't no folk song. Well, some people say a man is made out of mud. A poor man's made out of muscle and blood. Muscle and blood and skin and bone. A mind that's weak and a back that's strong. You load 16 tons. What do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. Well, St. Peter, don't you call me, 'cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. Well, I was born one morning, it was drizzling rain. Fighting and trouble is my middle name. I was raised in a canebrake by no mama line. There ain't no high tone woman make me walk the line 16 times. Now what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. Well, St. Peter, don't you call me, 'cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. I was born one morning, it was drizzling rain. Fighting and trouble in my middle names. I was raised in a canebrake by an old mama line. There ain't no high tone woman make me walk the line. You load 16 times. What do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. Well, St. Peter, don't you call me, 'cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. Coming better, step aside. A lot of men didn't and a lot of men died. I got one fist of iron, the other steel. If my right one don't get too well, my left one will. Yeah, 16 tons, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. Well, St. Peter, don't you call me, 'cause I can't go. Cause I owe my soul. Stop that. Soul. to the company store. Some Travis folk song. I'm gonna do another song that's not a folk song. I always call this like a ditty song, but it's really not that. The story goes like this, and I've checked it out a number of ways. They all tell it the same way, so I guess it's true. Tex Williams said he went over to the house, Travis's house, one afternoon, and Tex says, Travis is out there whitewashing the fence. What's that mean? He's painting the fence white? I said, oh, whitewash one, it says painting the fence, but they don't. He says, I got over there, and I said, Trav, I'm going in the studio tomorrow, and producer doesn't know if we got anything that might be a hit or not. Do you have anything laying around that I could record that you think would be a hit song for me? Travis said, I can't think of a thing, Tex. You know, we can make something up, be all I can think of. Well, I need to well, give me a cigarette, and then I'll get my pad. I'm out of cigarettes. Tex said, and Travis said, I can't write nothing if I don't have something to puff on. So Tex said he went in the house. He's in there about 10, 15 minutes. He comes out laughing, puffing on a cigarette, smoking on whatever, writing on this pad. This is the first million-selling record for a brand-new company at the time called Capitol Records. It was a brand-new company. This is their first million-selling record. You can Google it. Yeah, all because Travis wanted a cigarette. Well, I'm a fella with a heart of gold, with the ways of a gentleman, I've been told, the kind of a fella that would never harm a flea. But if me and certain character met that old boy in front of that cigarette, I'd murder that son of a gun in the first degree. Well, it ain't that I don't smoke myself, and I don't reckon it handy health none. I've smoked them all my life, and I ain't dead yet. But nicotine slaves are all the same, at a betting party or a poker game. Everything stops while you have a cigarette. Smoke, smoke, smoke that cigarette. Puff, 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 and if you smoke yourself to death, tell St. Peter at the Golden Gate, you had to make him wait, you just got to have another cigarette. Well, the other night I had a date with the prettiest girl in these 50 states, high-bred, uptown, fancy little thing. She said she loved me, and it seemed to me that everything's about like it ought to be, so hand in hand we strolled down Lover's Lane. She was oh so far from a cake of ice, and our kissing party was going real nice, so help me, Hannah, I think I'd have been there yet. But she gave me a kiss and a little squeeze. She said, Bresh, man, excuse me, but I got to have myself another cigarette. Smoke, smoke, smoke that cigarette. Puff, 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 and if you smoke yourself to death, tell St. Peter at the Golden Gate, you had to make him wait, you just got to have another cigarette.
You've been listening to Merle Travis's son, Thom Bresh, playing a few of his dad's songs. Thom started that set with Cookie Jar, followed by Guitar Rag, Dark as a Dungeon, 16 Tons, and Smoke, Smoke, Smoke That Cigarette. Later in this show, we'll hear some classic songs picked by Merle Travis himself, as well as some other terrific thumb pickers. But after a short break, I think I'll head down to the vault for a visit with the one and only Mark Jones. This is Ozark Highlands Radio. Thank you. It's come to that part of our show where I like to go down into the vault and visit with my buddy Mark Jones, who always seems to pick out some interesting music for us to play in our segment of old-time songs from the Ozark Folk Center. Let's go down there now. Hey, Mark.
Dave, you know, I'm so excited because I got something I want to share with you.
Well, what is it?
Well, I'm looking around here and found a recording of my buddy, Dean Hinesley. He's been around here for a long time, worked for the Forestry Service down here, and he's always supported and played with just everybody that ever asked him, and he's still doing it.
He is still at it. I know Dean, too.
And then there's Andrew Kennard, who's another buddy of mine that I met when I first come down in this part of the country.
Yeah, Kennards, those are another big family here in Stone County. There's still a lot of Kennards around.
That's true. And he plays guitar, and they do some awful good guitar picking. They are playing a tune called I Don't Love Nobody.
I remember that one. Your mom played that too, didn't she?
She did. Yeah. She played a little bit different version of it. She had a second part.
Well, let's listen to Andrew Kennard and Dean Hinesley playing I Don't Love Nobody. That was a mighty fine version. Those guys can pick.
Yes, sir. They sure can. They're good friends of mine, and you can't go wrong with having good friends like that. Boy, I'm just so glad you come down here, and I hope you enjoyed it.
That was some mighty fine picking. Thanks a lot, Mark.
You bet.
Danny Dozier is an Arkansas native and proud of it. He's one of the area's premier guitar players, well-versed in the Merle Travis thumb-picking style. Danny has worked with a wide variety of performers over the years, including Grandpa and Ramona Jones, Omar and the Howlers, and a band from right here in Mountain View, the Leatherwoods. On top of that, he's one of the nicest guys around. Here's some hot picking from Danny Dozier.
Called the Fuller Blues there for, I think he wrote the Fuller Blues after the Fuller Brush Company, maybe. Here's one if you start out trying to play some Merle Travis music, this is one you always want to try to work up, and you'll probably hear it a bunch over here this weekend. One of my favorites of his called I'll See You in My Dreams. Thank you. Thank you. Here's one called the Saturday Night Shuffle. I watched a great guitar player, no longer with us, Marcel Daddy, that kind of got this arrangement from this.
That was Batesville, Arkansas native Danny Dozier playing Fuller Blues, I'll See You in My Dreams, Saturday Night Shuffle, and an old gospel tune, I'll Fly Away. Randy Buckner also plays the Merle Travis style of thumbpicking, as well as teaching guitar, banjo, ukulele, and mandolin in Springfield, Missouri. A Springfield native, Randy has been playing guitar since 1973. He studied jazz at Middle Tennessee State University and has shared the stage with many great musicians, including the legend himself, Merle Travis. Here he is on our stage at last year's Merle Travis tribute.
Thank you. There we go. Thank you. Thank you so much. Appreciate it. Thank you.
Missouri Thumbpicker Randy Buckner, playing some Merle Travis classics, The Cannonball Rag, Why Do We Always Hurt the One We Love, So Round, So Firm, So Fully Packed, and Blue Smoke. After this break, we'll hear some thumbpicking from the man who invented that style, the great Merle Travis. You're listening to Ozark Highlands Radio. Welcome back to Ozark Highlands Radio. Merle Robert Travis was an American country and western singer, songwriter, and guitarist born in Rosewood, Kentucky. His songs' lyrics often discussed both the lives and the economic exploitation of American coal miners. Among his many well-known songs are 16 Tons, I'm a Pilgrim, and Dark as a Dungeon. However, it's his unique guitar style, still called Travis picking by guitarists, as well as his interpretations of the rich musical traditions of his native Muhlenberg County, Kentucky, for which he is best known today. Here is Merle himself, recorded in 1979 at our first Merle Travis tribute here at the Ozark Folk Center State Park.
This 9-pound hammer, it's a little too heavy for my size, for my size. I'm going on the mountain, gonna see my baby, but I ain't coming back. Well, I ain't coming back. Roll on, buddy. Just how can I roll when the wheels won't go? Roll on, buddy, put your load of coke. Tell me how can I roll when the wheels won't roll? Hazard, just to get a little brew, just to get a little brew. Well, when I'm long gone, make my tombstone out of number 9 coal, out of number 9 coal. Just roll on, buddy, don't you roll so slow. Well, how can I roll when the wheels won't go? Roll on, buddy, pull your load of coal. How can I roll when the wheels won't go? Just how can I roll when the wheels won't go?
Well, thank you very much. You know, that song's got me into a lot of trouble, really. I made up the verse, "It's a long way to Harlan, it's a long way to Hazard." Which these two towns are in East Kentucky. And I was born and raised in West Kentucky, in the coal fields of West Kentucky, in Muhlenberg County. Now, I've run into a whole lot of people say, "Hey, I'm up from your part of the country, up around Harlan and Hazard." I said, "No, I'm sorry. You see, I'm not from up that part of the country. I'm all the way across the state from Muhlenberg County." They say, "Yeah, but you sung about it on that record that you made." And I say, "Well, I've sung about heaven a lot of time. Nobody ever accused me of being from there." Some people go to school to learn how to teach. Some people go to school to learn how to preach. If you can't preach without going to school, you ain't no preacher, you're an educated fool, and that's all. That's all. Better change your way of living, for the good Lord's sake, that's all. Now, a feller I know, he's a miser man, keeps on trying to save all the money he can. But when that undertaker lets a man down, where's he gonna spend his money? Under the ground, and that's all. That's all. Better change your way of living, for the good Lord's sake, that's all. Come from monkeys, some people say, but the good book don't tell us that way. If you believe that monkey tale like some people do, I'd rather be a monkey brother than you, and that's all. That's all. Better change your way of living, for the good Lord's sake, that's all. Well, my little song is finished. My little song is through. I didn't necessarily mean to sing a song for you. But if you don't like the way the little song goes, it's a pretty good sign. I've been a-tromping on your toes, and that's all. That's all. Better change your way of living, for the good Lord's sake. That's all. And that's all. Sweet temptation, that's what you are to me. That's all you'll always be, it seems. Sweet temptation, you smile and pass me by. Still you occupy my dream. Maybe I've got lots of hidden charms you'd find if you would hold me in your arms. But you're just sweet temptation, a diamond in the rough. You make it awful tough for me. Delicious peach is always out of reach, they say. Well, sweet temptation, you're just a little flirt. Don't you know you might get hurt that way? Someday you may get a big surprise by someone who will make you realize that you're just sweet temptation, a diamond in the rough. You make it awful tough for me. Make it awful tough for me. Thank you. I have no idea why I threw that tune in, but it's a little old tune. They said do old time songs, and that was written and recorded over 30 years ago, so maybe it's an old time song. And so's this. Okay. Incidentally, I've heard all this stuff before myself. If you've ever heard of me, which you probably haven't, and have any suggestions, I'll be glad to do whatever you suggest. Anybody want suggest? Somebody said, I'm a pilgrim. Somebody said, 16 tons. All right, first we'll do I'm a pilgrim, okay? Now then, here is a tune I done, I done it 400 years ago in an old 78 record albums. And then some 8 years ago, I done it with a Nitty Gritty Dirt Band with Lester Flatt and Earl Scruggs and Roy Acuff and Mother Maybelle Carter. And tell me, who all was on it? Who's on it? Doc Watson, and who else? Anyhow, they sold a million records of that album, and I'm sure I didn't help any, but somebody said, sing I'm a Pilgrim, and I'll do it. Proudly. Here it is. I am a pilgrim, and I'm a stranger, traveling through this wearisome land. Well, I've got a home in that yonder city, good Lord. And it's not, Lordy, and it's not made by hand. I've got a mother, a sister, and a brother who have gone to that sweet home. And I'm determined to go and see them, good Lord, over on, Lordy, over on that other shore. As I go down to the River of Jordan, just to bathe my weary soul. If I could touch but just the hem of his garment, good Lord, I believe, Lordy, I believe that it would make me whole. I'm a pilgrim and a stranger, traveling through this wearisome land. I've got a home in that yonder city, good Lord. And I believe that it was not made by hand. Thank you. You know, I don't want you to go home and say that Merle Travis done any sort of, he come out and done a show. No. I feel that I'm out here visiting with a bunch of old friends. I feel that you're my friends. And fans, no, there's no such thing. And we had a contest this afternoon. Well, we started at 10 o'clock. Then we're down at 2 o'clock, and I went down to I took a nap, and I'm not, somebody snapped their fingers, and I get awake. But I don't have a planned program of any sort. So I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll just stay here till daylight and do them all. How's that? Now, what else should I do? Re-enlist with blues, John Henry, 16. No. Riddleless blues. Somebody over here. Where in the world did you hear riddleless blues? I worked in a little picture. I've had the pleasure of playing in something like 40 motion pictures, most of them westerns, where you sat around a campfire and a butane tank was sitting out there and the fire was coming out through a little phony campfire, you know, and singing. But this reenlistment blues he mentioned was the only award-winning picture I was ever in. And I was, it was called From Here to From Here to Eternity. And I sang a song called Reading This Blues in the Picture. I told my sister about it. She went down and she sneezed and missed my complete part. So you know how much I had to do. So we better leave Reading This Blues alone. Well, we don't. John Henry's been done. Let the poor boy rest. That's what we do. Let me do this. A song about the state where I was born and half raised, Kentucky. An awful lot of words are spelled the same, with a different meaning, you see. But here's a brand new way to spell heaven, according to me. You take a K and an E, an N and a T, a U and a C-K-Y. That spells Kentucky, but it means paradise. Take a chicken and you kill it, put him in a skillet and you fry him up a golden brown. That's southern cooking, and it's mighty nice. It don't cover a lot when you look on a map. But then I wasn't studying geography when I was sitting on my mammy's lap. You take a K and an E, a N and a T, a U and a C-K-Y. That spells Kentucky, but it means paradise. Studying geography when I was sitting on my mammy's lap. You take a K and an E, an N and a T, a U and a C-K-Y. That spells Kentucky, but it means paradise. That spells Kentucky, but it means paradise.
That was country music legend Merle Travis, recorded at the Ozark Folk Center in May 1979. These were some of Merle's most popular songs. He played 9-Pound Hammer, followed by That's All, Sweet Temptation, I Am a Pilgrim, and Heaven Spells Kentucky. Thanks for listening to this special thumb-picking edition of Ozark Highlands Radio. For more information about our annual Merle Travis tribute, check out ozarkfolkcenter.com. For all of us here at Ozark Highlands Radio, I'm Dave Smith. See you next week.
Ozark Highlands Radio is produced by Jeff Glover. Executive producer is Darren Dorton. Additional support for this program comes from the Committee of 100, proudly supporting the Ozark Folk Center State Park since 1974, and by Arkansas State Parks, with 52 unique reasons to visit the natural state. More information online at arkansasstateparks.com. For information on upcoming shows and events, we are on the web at ozarkhighlandsradio.com. Until next time, I'm Donna Farrar.